Don't Skype them in, or don't, you know, project, you know, televise your live escape, but bring them into the house.
Right.
See, there's something about being
in the house. Yes.
It's not just about the physical edifice, but there's safety in the house. There's power in the house. When we come together, those of like-minded faith, we encourage one another. We build one another.
Right.
And so there's something powerful about being
in the house.
Yeah. But in their directives, if they weren't in the house, they said, listen, your life is in your own hands. If you're not being obedient to the words that we're giving you, your life is in your hands. They warned her. They said, if you bring your family and your mother and your brother and everyone in this house, when we come, they will be saved. So much so that if anyone that is in this house is killed, it'll be our life for yours. But if you are not in the house, you cannot be saved.
That's right.
Rahab, stand with me this morning.
Yes.
Rahab and her family were saved, not just because they were in the house, but because they were obedient the word that was given. Because their house crumbled just like everything else in that wall that day.
Right.
But because they were obedient to the word that was given to them, they were saved.
Yes.
So is the same for us this morning. It's not necessarily about being in a specific house or being in an edifice. It's not about a waving of our hands and lifting up a music and song, even though that's nice. But what the Lord is looking for us is obedience.
Right.
For Hiel was disobedient and it cost him his life.
Right.
But not only his life, but all those who came after him, so that his inheritance was cut off.
That's right.
There is an inheritance that is for us as well. But that inheritance can only come to us if we are obedient to the word of God.
Yes.
But there are those who are coming after us. There are Rahabs in the world and those who are looking for a way to get out, and they're looking for an exit point. They're looking for a way to escape out of their situation. And they're looking to us. They're looking to those who have been obedient to the word of God, looking to those who have built a firm foundation in their own lives so that others can come in and stand strong and go further. But if we rebuild Jericho, if we revisit those things that the Lord has said were accursed, then not only are we riding ourselves out, but we're destroying a foundation that others could have come in and built upon as well. You see, this walk is not just about us.
Right.
It's the decisions that we make, the lives that we live, it's not just about us.
That's right.
For as in the natural, parents try to do whatever they can to create a firm foundation that their children can build upon, so ought we as a church to do the same for the generations which are to come.
That's right.
And the decisions that we make today, the choices that we make today, the lifestyle that we live today will be the foundation upon which others will build upon. The things that we allow in the church today, the things that we say go, that we say are right today, will be what the church of the future will build upon.
Yeah.
What foundation are we building this morning? Are we building a firm foundation that's firmly rooted in the word of God, that seeks to do everything that the Lord has commanded us to do? Or are we building a foundation that desires to do our own thing, that desires to follow according to our own way, that does whatever goes and whatever feels good, whatever makes most sense to us?
Mm.
Are we building a foundation that is unshakable and immovable because it's rooted in the truths of the words that the Lord has spoken to us?
Mm.
Or are we building a foundation that says it's okay to be in the house on Sunday and do whatever you want to do the rest of the week as long as you come and you punch your time clock in church? Are we building a foundation that says it's okay to live life as you desire it and do whatever you desire to do just as long as you look the part? Or are we building a foundation? Are we building a foundation that allow others to see that city whose foundation and maker
is God?
Is God. I don't know about you this morning, but I want to build a firm foundation. I want to build a firm foundation that's rooted in the truth of this book, no matter what it costs. For there's a price to pay, it's true. But there's a greater price to pay if we rebuild Jericho in our lives and take up those things that we said were accursed. For if we follow the Lord, if we follow his commandments, and we say that the ways of the world are not the way to go, but if we return to those ways, the Bible says if we return to the things that we call the curse, and we are a transgressor.
Mm.
And there's no inheritance laid up for the transgressor. I want us to pray this morning together that the Lord would examine our foundation, for your foundation will be manifest by the works that come forth.
That's right.
I want the Lord to examine our foundation this morning to make sure that not just as individuals, but as a house, that we are building a firm foundation that others can come in and build upon and go further in the work than we. I want us to pray this morning that the Lord would examine our hearts and examine us to make sure that we don't have any hidden treasures buried beneath our foundation that would rock our foundation, would shake our foundation should any trouble come our way.
Help us, Lord.
But I want the Lord to examine our foundation. For when you go to purchase a house, you have an inspector that comes in. And
yes.
Some inspectors are good and some inspectors are not so good. Some inspectors will kind of just take a glance at what looks on the outside and say, okay, everything looks good. But there are some inspectors who know what they're doing, who have experience, who've been around for a little while. They'll take out their instruments and they'll prod and they'll look and they'll do what they have to do to make sure that the foundation is sound.
Right.
I don't want to base our perceptions on what we see or what we think is sound. But I want the Lord to examine us this morning so that he can say, well done.
Yes.
I want our pastor to lead us in prayer this morning as we desire for the Lord to take a look and see if we are rebuilding Jericho in our lives.